Hi everyone, this is Sarah Fezio, and today I'm going to be doing a pour, maybe two pours on 8x10 canvas for a potential patron that has requested some specific colors. So I am, the house paint I was going to use is going to be a little bit too light, I think, so I am going to try to use some heavy body paint, Napthol crimson, and some Liquitex pouring medium. Now, I don't know if this is going to work because the heavy bodies don't tend to mix very well, but we're going to try it so you guys can see what it's like to actually try to mix a heavy body with pouring medium. Plenty of blue, I think, for what we're going to do. This is Glidden Diamond House Paint. I'm just going to add some water. We'll give that a stir. This is already a very fluid paint, but I'm just adding a little bit of water just to make it a tad more fluid. Now, the room that I'm doing this for has a blue wall. So we go. My blue is ready to go. See, that didn't take long. House paint doesn't take hardly any time. We're going to use white house paint because I would use black house paint and white artist loft, but I don't have any black house paint. I've got a brown, but this is just white house paint that I've subdivided. And you're actually going to see what happens when you put an additive in the white, I think. Maybe. We'll see. I'm still debating. Someone's like, ask me, how do you know what you're going to add to what? And I'm like, well, unless you're doing something that you've already done before, like the same process, you don't always know. You're like, oh, we'll see how it goes when I get there. You don't have to think it through that much. This is kind of like a color study. So I've got white. Normally I mix up more white paint, but in this case I'm not. However, I am going to add some GAC 800. I was out for a while. It came with new packaging, so I hope this is new packaging by Golden and not old packaging. And the person I bought it from on Amazon sent me old stuff, so I'm hoping this is new stuff. And yeah, it's white looking, but it's not really white. It dries clear. And that's just to help reduce crazing. Although I don't usually get much crazing, but when you use house paint, it doesn't dry flat. It's not super flat. I like that. I like it looking like it's a painting where there's texture on it. But that's just my preference. I could always put a clear coat of resin if I really wanted to. I'm not a big fan of resin. I still have art resin that they sent me that I need to try. So that is on the agenda for some point in the future. When I buy a respirator, even though you're not supposed to use one, I just don't have a very ventilated area. And I'm just gonna add a little bit more pouring medium. It's a little bit thinner than I wanted. Still And there's still a shortage on pouring medium for some reason. I have a half gallon left, but I'm conserving that just in case. And I tried Golden Artist Colors polymer medium. Golden polymer medium, and I liked it. And of course you can try PVA glue, which I'm not gonna do. I did order something from Derivan Matisse, something that we can use to pour, and that should be arriving from Jerry's Artarama shortly, hopefully within the week, so I can do a video to show you that. Because Matisse, or that company, they're from Australia, I believe. And they have colors, really awesome colors, like Australian Sienna and Southern Ocean Blue, heavy body paints that I have. And that's not a company that comes to your mind right away. So I did decide to order some of their products. I got a gift card for my birthday to Jerry's, and so that's what I got. And hopefully when it shows up, I will show you. Now, normally I use white, show you how to use that medium and see how it works. Okay, so normally I use white for my base, but because the walls are blue, we're gonna go with the black base. I have four colors, so I kind of feel like we need another color in there, but I usually pour with the base and then four colors, but we'll see. Let us add nothing to the blue, silicone to the white, enough silicone. And y'all, I had an accident on my shelf because all my Dimethicone product spilled out. All over. So as you can see, my hands are now covered. Can't have that. Which means we now need new gloves. In a minute, anyway. I looked at my shelf and I was like, what cup of water? I didn't have water up there. How that? No, it wasn't water, sadly. So I'm just going to mix the Dimethicone up real good here. Okay. Now, okay, I'm just going to put a little bit of black on the canvas. I don't really use a lot of black. You know that? I really don't. I'll have to go back and touch up the sides, because when I scrape it with this, you can see it. Okay. And if you're wondering, the black is Mars black. There are several different kinds of black. All right. Cups for later. Okay, here's my cup. Maybe I'll use a bigger one. I like these cups because they're narrow. So the paint moves. If I fill it up, it'll probably fit on there. I don't know how much. I won't fill it up though. Okay, here's white at the bottom. I'm saving some white. Now, blue, and I'm pouring from high up. I already have cells in that. I poured too much, but I have more blue. So white, blue. Black. Looks good. And red. So that's that much on there. I'm going to use a 4x4 canvas panel. Actually, I'm going to do a flip cup. I cleaned up some. I did something with my aluminum foil. Oh, it's back there. Alright, another piece. Awesome. So it's very foamy. I won't say foamy, bubbly. Because I was pouring the paint from a great height. I'm actually going to drop it here. Then whatever's left in the cup, I'll pour down here. So when I do that, I like to really turn the cup like that, which it turned out everywhere, but that's okay. Can you see that? Hopefully. Oh, this is going to be sweet. Why am I pouring it there? I should be pouring it over here. Okay. Oh, that's going to look sweet. I don't want it to rest too long. Too much paint. Sometimes the painting has a life of its own, or mind of its own, you know that? I'm getting a ton of cells forming. It's not torched or anything. There's no white though, so that's not good. Just going to cover the side real quick. And it's pitting from the Dimethicone. I don't even need to do anything to that. It just looks pretty good. I think the colors didn't blend too much. But what I poured there could have probably, I could have probably used that on 2 8x10s, honestly. I don't know if you guys can see that. So up here I have pitting. Here's lacing, a little bit in here. Have to be very careful. This is a very big thing you need to realize. When your hands are covered with paint like this, this is when you drip something right in the middle of your painting. And it doesn't do what you want it to do. And then you're like, no. Happens all the time. I don't have a clean finger. I don't like that here. Because it's pitting. I'm gonna take this and just kind of wipe that off. This black is really thick. Okay. All those colors look good together. I got a gray from some of the mixing though, and there's gray and pink in there. Okay. Got more cells. More cells are forming over here. I didn't even get close to it. Yeah, I don't think that's what he had in mind. And that red looks darker because the other colors mix with it. No problem. Hold on, let me zoom out. We're going to do another one. You can't really see the top of the canvas. Hold on. I think I moved the that's what that one looks like. And the white corner down there really is white. This is actually white. There, you see it's a white corner. Where'd my white go? Okay, so into my dirty pour cup that I still have, I am going to add white just on top of whatever was in there, okay? Not a lot, because I don't need a lot. White, blue, and black, a little bit. That's all I need in there. This is for canvas number two. This one, I could probably add some sort of white in there and it would look better, but I have some left. Let's see. Or go back over it with string gel. I definitely have more black in that other cup, so okay, that looks a little bit better. There's at least a little more white and a little more black in it. Okay. Most of it's covered too on this side. I don't know about the other side. This has no paint on it right here. All down here on the front. Okay, that's okay. I'll mess with that later. I'm gonna move that down there. I don't have to move it that far. Okay, you can. Now I have my other canvas. Let me wipe my hands real quick on a rag. So you can kind of see the top one. The black kind of sunk in a little bit. It's not as noticeable on the top now. Here is another canvas. Woohoo! There you go. I know you can't see the top one the whole way, but let's see. I want you to at least be able to see some of it, and then when I'm done, I'll take the camera down and show you both of them up close. Okay, so this one, we're gonna do a little bit different. Gloves. Oh, I forgot that pouring medium. Pouring medium doesn't come off your hands. I forgot, I use pouring medium in the red. That's gonna be lovely. It doesn't scrape off. If you're lucky, you can peel it off though. It's on there for a while. If you don't get it off right away, it's gonna be on there for a while. Okay, here's black. There's not really any white paint left, and my white cup has been contaminated, so luckily, white was house paint and will only take a second to mix up. White house paint. It's okay, I'll use whatever's left later. White house paint, water. Blue house paint. If I can get, I can't get the lid back on. Water. Y'all aren't seeing me in the camera, are you?
No.
Okay, white. I have to be careful not to splash the other painting. Black's already ready. Okay, I like that. Black. White is ready. Blue almost ready. Oh yeah, and I said I was going to add another color. Maybe not. Blue. Red, that's all I'm going to mix up. I don't even remember which one I added to which, but this time I'm adding silicone to the black and the white. And I'm monitoring the other canvas just to make sure it's not pitting really bad on the canvas. The thicker your paint is, the less likely it is to pit. Okay, so that one didn't work out too well. So I'm just going to just do a pour on this little bitty 8x10 canvas. It's gonna be so funny. Pour. Blue. Blue. I think I should get another canvas for this. Would help if I had better aim. But I don't. Okay. I have cells, maybe. Let's see. Good enough. And I'll do another one after this. Okay, here we go. I'm kind of quiet, sorry. Concentrating, you kind of get in the zone and you don't think about much. That's neat. Some of it's really neat. So I have red, white, black, and blue in there, which is good. Pits, I think, over here. No, not too bad. There's a red stripe in there. Oh. Those are just air bubbles popping, I think. Well, we definitely didn't have as much blending. This one's cool. This one's okay. The red, though, is bleeding into the other colors. So, yes, I'm taking pictures. Sorry. I'm doing this on purpose because I'm not keeping it like that. This one I like okay. It'll dry really dark though. I didn't even do my pour. Hold on. You're supposed to swipe faster. See what happens when I swipe faster? Really fast, but you gotta have stuff up and then you spill it on the canvas like that. There we go, really fast. Those are little cells. I like the corner up there. I don't like the other corner, but I'm at an awkward angle. So this is the swiping technique. Just so you know. Probably never use that cookie sheet that I'm using down there again for anything. Okay, this is so abstract, like you have no idea. I'm going to leave that little black spot there. Some of it I didn't swipe, but some I did. I don't know. See, I tend to like these really cool, crazy looking, like, pieces. I actually love this piece so much more than that one. Me personally. That one's okay. It will not be that color. It will dry so dark you won't be able to see it. Let's swipe that one too. Let me go get something to... Okay, like... I really like this one, like a lot. Like it is a, to me, it is a painting you could just get lost in, if that makes sense. So before I move it though, I want to make sure the side's covered because I've got all sorts of crazy colors on this canvas and I'm not going to be able to just put paint on there to fill it up. That makes sense. Okay, so I need to cover this one. I'll just take some from that other painting that dripped off. It's okay. I can't even see what's in between them. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to stop the video and then I'll start it again after I move this one and we'll swipe that one before it dries too much. Okay, but before I do that, I'm not sure you're going to be able to see it because autofocus is off because I know the camera goes in and out. I have another camera that I'm going to try, but it's like I order a cable. I need this cable too. Oh, I order a cable. Oh, it's the wrong cable. Oh my gosh. All right. Can you see that gorgeousness? Like, it is freaking adorable. I love it. Okay. Eek. Oh, the other side is almost completely and totally filled. Woohoo! Just a little bit right here. Just gonna add white. There's cells going down the side. Sorry for my head. Oh my gosh, I love it! And this red is a heavy body. That red should not dry that much darker. This one is like 1,000 times. I love it. Okay, towel, to wipe the hands some. Let me go get a cart or something, not a cart, a tray to put this painting on. Take to the other room, and I'll be back. Okay, canvas is moved. Here we go. Yeah, totally different looking. I like this better. It's still not going to have much red in it. I still have more black. Okay, so I'm just gonna cover the sides, which have a lot of paint on them already. And it's really hard, kind of hard to cover the side when I have that, like, the canvas like this, but okay. That looked funny because there was just one white corner, I thought. Oh yeah. Yeah, I kind of want this one to look weird too. I mean, that's kind of psychedelic. I think. It's my feelings. Y'all might think something totally different. Okay, so I now have two canvases with all sorts of funky stuff on them. It's pretty awesome. This one, the red won't be near as bright. But everyone has their own, in reality, everyone has their own taste. Like, one person may love the weird abstractness of this, and someone may look at it, like my granddad, and be like, no. I, however, like it. Y'all can leave your comments below. I got one more to do. Okay, we're just gonna set this one back where it was. The edge. And I'm gonna need some new canvas packs because I'm almost out of 8x10s again. Okay. Yeah, there's some other color in the white, but that's okay. It's not a lot, just a little bit. Coating the canvas with white. Well, like, did I really mix up that much paint? Yeah, I did. So 8x10 is 80 square inches. 80 times 3 is 240. That's 316. That's 3/4 of a 16x20. So the paint that I mixed up would almost cover a 16x20. Okay, here's my cup. Fingers crossed. Still some in there. It's a pretty red. That I don't really want to make that disappear. don't know if y'all saw that, but my little thing almost fell out right on top of my painting, and that would have not made me happy. I would have probably been screaming. Okay, does anybody else see the word mud in there? Yeah. I do. So we can't have anything that says mud. Okay. That's three paintings, 3 8x10s. Now I'm ready to do a pour over the other one. So I'm gonna stop here. That's three of them. They all look, this one looks totally different. This one looks totally different than the other ones. I'm just going to let it sit for a while. Then I'll show them different pictures and say, well, which kind of style do you like the best? I think we'll do that. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching these little three red, white, black, and blue paintings. If you did, make sure you give me a thumbs up or hit the like button. Also, subscribe to my channel to see more videos and be on the lookout for my test with Duravan Matisse medium that I'm going to use to pour with. And thank you guys for watching. Lots of love. Bye.